So in the O&M area, we're always worried about whether things are running and how well they're running. So it's a big, big topic because we touch every piece of equipment in the plant in the maintenance realm. The operators have to do so much that is hard to do because they're controlling everything that's going on there. So everybody is busy in these power plants.
Well, certainly in the last couple of years, we've had a very nearly serious failure of the biggest dam in the U.S. These incidents are pointing to the need for continued evolution of dam safety tools, of risk-informed decision-making, going beyond strictly deterministic assessments into what could happen, and if it does, how can we prevent it?
There are quite a few things that we're going to discuss. One is the changing regulations and uncertainty going on now with environmental laws, the Endangered Species Act, Clean Water Act, other areas. Hydropower's role in transitioning to a carbon-free future, clean energy sources. Looking at international perspectives in sustainable hydropower development and related areas.
So in the equipment and technology track, you will see the cutting edge technology, the advancements in technology that are making hydro more relevant today than it ever has been.
One of the first things I think that is very exciting to others will be to be providing an international perspective in terms of asset strategies and the market trends. We're going to be looking at the goals and the visions of others and how they see themselves in working towards meeting those goals. Another topic that I think is going to be very exciting for folks is to talk about the flexibility of hydropower and what hydropower brings. Not only what it brings, but what it's asked to bring into the industry, particularly in the area of how we integrate the renewable resources. And finally, another topic of discussion is going to be about data. And what can we do with data? How valuable is data? And just as important, how do we protect that data?